G'day everybody. Welcome back, Stationeers. After that brief interlude with Tin Can and me dying repeatedly, I'm hoping that I'll be able to manage to cool down the greenhouse slash production area slash everywhere area enough today that we can actually get the proper greenhouse going, which would be really nice. Tin Can appears to be PC build simulator in hardcore mode. Could be. Could be. Let's get going. I did not get around to doing any mining in between last week and this week, so we'll have to do some mining potentially today if I want to keep building various bits and pieces. Sadly, we were not able to use the fusion furnace of the air conditioner to actually any sort of explosion done last time either. Now, the question is, how do you guys feel about cheesing the aircon? I don't feel like the aircon does enough to be worth, like, because I can deconstruct it, reconstruct it, and then turn it back on again, and it's empty. But I don't think if it, I kind of don't feel like it does enough to cool down this space to be worth it. So what I'm thinking about is, should I pressurize this loop here with outside gas? Because if I pressurize that loop, it should have a greater impact on cooling this space, because it's minus 60 degrees in there, but it's only 1 kilopascal, so it doesn't do much to take the heat out of this space. I think if I pressurize that loop, it might. Octonath, I would say that Mars is the best planet to start with to learn Stationeers. I don't need... The thing is... What's... So, Skadwin... Telling... Like, suggesting to play with heat exchangers... I effectively am. I just don't need an actual heat exchanger. Because what I've got here is a very basic system where I've got heat transferring to the exterior atmosphere more rapidly through these... radiators. So I'm doing that. I'm just doing it passively without the need of any power input. My thought was, though, to put some power out there and use a pressure thing to increase the speed of that heat transfer. So I'm wondering if these will be more effective. There. And there. Who knows? Be very difficult to test the difference between those. Oh, I know what I was thinking of doing. That's right. I was going to go out and mine some more water ice. That's what I was going to do. Yeah, in the air conditioner, it is heated gas. It's a very, very small volume of gas, which is why it gets to such an insanely high heat. And yes, by destroying that, you're destroying that small amount of gas. Where's water? Down there. There's some water ice. Because if I put a bunch of fresh ice into my water system, that's going to help me, one, gain more water. But two, it's going to help me cool down the space because it's going to drop the temp of my water that's already piped in there. And seems to be fairly effective at taking the heat out because the thermal capacitance of water is so high. Specific energy? Is that the term? Basically, the amount of energy required to raise water's temperature by a single degree is greater than a lot of other materials. This game can be complicated, but it does a reasonably good job of following real-world principles, so if you've done or even watched a few YouTube videos on chemistry and that have like talked about a bit of chemistry and physics over time, you'll probably be able to follow a lot of it. Where's my hole to the surface? There it is.
Jetpack on.
Let's turn the things off. I'll go shove this water ice in and then I'll go find another deposit. Oh, that's my other problem. Oh, I actually need a radiator on the outside for the water. I was wondering why it wasn't getting cooler. Why the outside water was staying so warm. Perseus, man, you've got to be more specific about that, because stream delay means asking questions like what are those blocks, rarely translate to something that I can interpret. The ones in the air that are transparent. There were transparent blocks in the air? Oh, that's my sensor lenses. That's showing what the material is. So that's O2, that's some iron, that sort of thing. That's my ore detector. Oh, I built the wrong one. Dang it. Poop. Built a regular gas one, not a proper one. No, it's not a mod. It's vanilla. I don't have any mods in this at all. Not even an ore mod to increase how much ore I get. The glasses are the best for making mining not painful. They're just one of those things that means that you're not spending ages running around for no good reason. Searching for something that you may have already stumbled straight past. Okay, let's try this again.
Jetpack on.
Okay, that should start dropping the temperature of that quite rapidly. Or at least balancing out the temperature transfer from inside. Then, turn you on. Let's shove this stuff in. Yeah, the UI for the machines has updated. There was a... that was ages ago, but a thing that allowed you to upgrade your machines. The radiators on insulated pipe, the way I assume that works is you've got the radiator connected directly to the pipe, everything else around it is insulated, but just not the radiator bit. That, there's no reason that shouldn't work. Thanks, Carl Das Lama. Thanks for the prime sub. The radiators are passive heat sinks, but if they're connected directly to the metal material of the pipe, then there's conduction between the material inside the pipe and the radiator, therefore heat exchange can occur. Just because the rest of the pipe is insulated doesn't mean that this can't work. So I disagree with you there, Scoudman. That visually looks like something that should work. Alright, what are we at? Temp-wise, what did that do? Took it down to 16 degrees. That's something. Unfortunately, because of those radiators, it's now warming up because it's daytime. But, you know. You get that. Some point I'm gonna want the dirt thingo so I can fill in some of these holes around my base. It's weird how little that seems to matter in this compared to, say, Space Engineers and most other building games I play, where I'm trying to protect the terrain around where my base is because I pick it based on aesthetics. But it just doesn't seem to matter in this. No, Scadwin, X is not good at transferring heat. The pollutant is only used by most people as their coolant system because it doesn't have another use. Water is actually far superior to pollutant for air conditioner coolant use. From everything that I've read up about it in the game. This water, and that'll probably be enough, I think. I don't know about the other gases compared to pollutant, but yeah, water is far superior to it. Unless that's changed, but when I looked at it, X did not have a higher specific heat capacity than water. looks like it's pretty much it. And I'm pretty close to full in my thingy anyway.
Jetpack on.
Yeah, Exco, I don't like looking at the big cheat sheet because it's got way too much information for me to find it to be useful. It's all, something else that I've found with games like Stationeers. It's really easy to get myself into a wiki hole where I'm just relying off other people's information. I feel like it's been pretty... I've managed to avoid that pretty well this playthrough by testing stuff, because I've got enough confidence that I can understand the systems and enough confidence that I'm not going to die. I can try something, and if it fails, try something different. And I'm having so much more fun as a result. And I know that's not for everyone. I know some people, the idea of having to muddle their way through isn't as fun. But for me, it is. And I'm pretty sure Capac takes the same approach to life in general. Which means it works for us, because we end up... playing together a lot. There, dog? That doesn't look like a nice way to do that. Now, speaking of dog, I need to remember to not run way, way over on this stream, because I've got to take Charlie to the vet. I've got an appointment booked in. Yeah, like, while there is a performance benefit to using water as coolant, you can easily get away with using other stuff. Like, on this initial greenhouse... with my tomatoes poking through the wall. The coolant here is just the pollutant from the air. And it's enough.
Jetpack on.
You don't need optimal in Stationeers. You can get by with good enough in a lot of situations, and I like that. Let's see how we're going temperature-wise inside. We started coming down to tolerable levels. We're 55 degrees down here, but it might be cooler up here because this is where all my cooling's happening. Down to 50. That's something, I suppose. Yeah, exactly, as in, not everything needs to be min-maxed, and... there was something I was talking about with Wasted in our, RimWorld stream. Games like Stationeers allow you that sort of... they allow you that imperfection by making the numbers a bit random and fudgeable enough. Unlike games like Factorio and Satisfactory. Which still sort of give you that, but it's less obfuscated. The numbering. But I like that I don't have to do perfection, because I like that it's gonna just work. Incognito, there have been updates to the version that I'm playing of this several times a week since I started this stream series, because they're so active with doing little changes to this. I do still need a recycler and centrifuge. Oh, we're down to not Bernie symbol on my HUD temperatures. We're down to 49 degrees in here. And my battery on my pad. My pad is dead. I feel like this one uses up a lot more power than the other one. Or I've kept leaving it on. I've probably kept leaving it on. Down to 49.2 degrees. It's still hotter than I would like to plant any seeds in. But suppose I can turn that air conditioner on again. What help it does? I got the materials to make more of those hydroponics. Yes. I plan to make a forest. That's what I plan to do. Oh, yeah. Yeah, actually, Mike, that could be something I could do today. Set up some displays for temperature and gas makeup, so I don't have to pull out the tablet every time. Now, how do I do that? So, first off, going to need some sort of sensor, and then some way to write that to a screen. Huh. So let's figure this out. Gas display circuit board. That seems like what I want. And I'm imagining that goes into a console. And then I'm going to want, guessing, a sensor. I'll have a look at how this works. So I reckon having the gas display somewhere up here makes the most sense. No, I'm not analyzing the pipe, I'm analyzing the gases here. Oh, wait a second. That's what I need to do. I need some walls. So what I'm thinking of doing with the walls is just putting an extra wall on the outside so I can keep the pressure in here but take off the cladding on the inside, which will allow me to see what I'm cabling. Or I could do the cabling from the outside. Nope. Yep. I should go back inside and do this. I think that's a smarter way of doing it. What is in this pipe? O2, H2, N2. Right. Just realized if I place the sensor, I place the console on the wall, I can then go outside and do the cabling and then come back inside without having to risk messing up my pressurization. I'm just worried if I put the walls out there, even though it should remain airtight, I'm worried that I'll accidentally remove more than just the wall I want to remove. I suppose I should put this on a little APC as well, maybe. It doesn't need it. It doesn't need it. Just do this from here. It's really hard to see, but that's a fairly simple network, so that should be fine. Overcomplicating things. I didn't need to go outside at all. Grab some glass. Disk. Gas sensor. Mode pressure, temperature. I'm gonna need multiple consoles. Alright, let's do another one. I'll just stick several consoles up that have each bit of info. Then, fine. Is there a... What do I need to do to be able to display what the gas makeup is? So I can display like how much CO2 and all that sort of information is there. Is that why Mike was saying digital pipe analyzer to put like an open-ended pipe and then connect that up? Power management console? Wait, is that the... Don't want the cartridge, I want a circuit board. Air control circuit board. What does that do? And I'm curious what this actually does. Device locking enabled, mode offline. Panic pressurize, panic depressurize. Oh. Transformer. Turbo volume pump. Oh, cool. So this would be a way to set up a system for like saving your gas if you suddenly lose pressure in your base. You can just smack that button and it'll try and pump everything out of the base. That's really cool. Don't think I'm going to use that though. It is cool. I feel like that's something to make when I, if I can drag Capac into this, because he'll be problematic on that front. What was the circuit board I used called? Advanced airlock, air control. Did I put... gas display. Graph display. What's the graph display? It's like power or something. The gas sensor reports gas percentages you can read with the chip or configuration readable via tablet. Yeah, I thought I'd have to do potentially some logic stuff to get this to work properly. There we go. That's two of the useful bits of information I can get from that sensor. Now, if I put if I were to move that sensor over to this side, I could then have a long row of consoles that I can hook up to a logic system to try and take the information out. But can I display on consoles, or do I need a normal display? I need a different type of display. Dual console. Yeah, Takaria did. The big underground base. We did have a power management display. We had some sort of LED displaying stuff. But I prefer the look of the consoles. Can I send information from this sensor to this console to have it display stuff, or do I have to put it on an LED? Because what I'd like to do is have something that sends the CO2 and the O2 readouts to Ideally, I'd like it to be a console because it looks nicer than the LEDs. Obviously, I'd need to use some logic to make that happen, which is fine. That's expected. Let's get this going up to the sensor. And then I shouldn't need to have a circuit board in the sensor, in the console, right? Maybe use a motion sensor to activate your displays. That's not a bad idea. Although it is nice that I can potentially read this from outside. Hash display only displays the item icon of the hash sent to it. What about the config board? See, this is why I want to mess with this stuff, because I have no idea how this stuff actually works, and if I don't mess with it, I don't think I'll understand it. So let's try. What I want to do is get a... So we want a logic I.O. to read the... Basically, I just want two logic I.O.s, one to read the sensor and then one to write this, that information to the console. See if that's even possible. So I have not tried it before. I'm going to do this in a sort of very temporary way by putting this in the floor, which I can't do. Dang it. I can do if I do this, though. Agent reader, match reader, slot reader, logic mirror. Whoops. So I want a logic reader and a logic writer. I think. So basically what I'm going to try and do is see if I can just use a very, very simple system to make this work. Oops, I keep putting that up there. I don't want it up there. Put it down here. Screwdriver. In. No readable devices on this network. What? Oh. That would explain things. I have not connected this side. Gas sensor. Variability, combustion, temperature, ratio of water, ratio of volatiles, ratio of pollutant, ratio of oxygen, ratio of nitrous, nitrogen, carbon dioxide. In logic reader. Out. Where's my label maker? CO2 console. Right, CO2 console, output variable. Oh, not open. What? Yeah, I thought this might have to be an LED. I didn't want it to be an LED. LEDs are ugly! Dang it! Graph display. All right, let's see what that graph display thing does. Graph. More gold. You shouldn't need a batch, right? I didn't think you'd need... So, Takari, my understanding of logic writers versus batch writers is logic writers write logic to a single item of a type. Batch writers write it to every item of that type. Other than that, I didn't think there were any differences. So it shouldn't make any impact whatsoever using a batch writer versus a logic writer in this instance, because all I'm doing is writing to a, was intending to write to one display. Oh. How does this work? Why can't it pick up from the gas sensor? It's so annoying. Well, poop. It's giving me nothing. Oh yeah, the logic aren't on, are they? Point 0.6. Is that matching up with what I see on this? 57%. So yeah, kinda. It's pretty close. So that's my CO2 readout, which obviously is not going to change at the moment particularly much because I'm not doing anything in this space that would change the gas makeup. The thing is, with this being the greenhouse, having a CO2 readout that'll at a glance tell me that things are precipitously dropping or have dropped. Can I change the timing of this? I don't think I can. Like, can I change the frequency that it moves across? Is there a way to do that? Because I'd like to see it over a longer period of time, because it looks like this will only give me, say, a minute or two window. I imagine that needs a bit more fiddling. I could throw out my... Let's have a look. Let's just make sure that the... I'm always nervous about opening my waste tank in these areas unless I've checked it. Okay, it's just CO2 and O2 in my gas canister. Fine.
Waste tank critical.
I think there's a tiny little blip. The tiniest, tiny, tiny blip. Because I've got so much gas in here. Oh.
Hunger, caution.
Have the reader only read every minute. Can you do that? You'd need some logic setup to do that, wouldn't you? Yeah, I don't think there is any simple way of doing that. Oh, that was some learning. Does make me think that I will change this up for an LED and see what I can do with an LED instead. What was I doing? Going to get food. Because we're almost down into can grow plants territory of temperature. Yeah, Dark Sand, it is pretty useless as a display if you can't change the scale. Pretty useless indeed. Give me all of the tomatoes. Still got quite a bit of water in there. Let's bring a few seeds across. See if I can, I'm pretty much ready to plant anyway. Might be able to hook up a temp dial to change scale setting if there is one for graph displays. I don't know what some of those words mean in this context. What I should do is make some lockers for up there so I can start putting my food in the lockers, or my seeds at least. It's a bit sad about the craft displays. It makes them of limited use. It does seem like you can compare two things to each other. Ooh. Because when I had the power thing... Yeah, it did look like... Corner locker. Overhead lockers. I hadn't looked at the different options that there were. Which way around does the shelf go? This way. There we go. Seed shelves. I'm guessing shelves will let stuff take damage in them more so than lockers, maybe? I can't see why you would need one over the other anymore. Yeah, Shadowstar, that's kind of what I was thinking. Because this graph display allows you to put two pieces of information to compare against each other, I was wondering if I could put CO2 versus O2 and see what it shows then. Because then it'll put a line in between the two. Because most of the gas in here is CO2 and O2, so I don't really need to worry about the nitrogen percentage. But I'll need another two logic chips, which I can do in a sec. Yeah, let's do it. Let's see what happens. That means two more logic IO. It may just add the two up, but we'll see. It probably will just add the two up. I'm almost certain you're right on that, that it's just going to add them up. And I'm out of cable. Of course I'm out of cable. That was one of the things I said I was going to make up between last week and this week. That I did not do. Will a math chip help? A math chip would allow me to output a different number, which gets sent to the graph. Actually, that gives me an idea. If I have a memory and set it to either 1 or minus 1, and then compare the CO2 to the memory, it should put the graph line in the middle of the graph. Because I'll then be setting my maximum. Let's try that. I think that could work. I think. Hey, Marathi. Hey, Nab. So, pop this down as well. Do I have room? No. All right, I'm just going to try. Let's just see what this does first, and then I'm going to try the memory, because I think the memory can work. I think the memory can do exactly what I want it to do, which is show me, which will allow me to set a scale on this. Because the issue is that this says 0.6, which is useless because the time scale on this is so short that I'm never going to see the graph deteriorating. But if instead that was set at 1 and 0.6 was in the middle, I'd see that the graph was lower to the bottom, which would be enough indicator that something's gone wrong. So, that means the in will be, again, the gas sensor. Variable, in this case, we wanted to see what error ratio oxygen was. And will be, I've got to label these now. Do ratio logic output. Now let's grab the disk. And with those two, it has subtracted it. That is almost certainly the oxygen level subtracted. Okay. Does it decide to do that, and in what order? Huh. Ah, no, Bellacrack, this does not have realistic gas requirements, otherwise we need a lot more nitrogen. It requires a minimum amount of oxygen for human breathability and a minimum amount of CO2 for plant function. Okay, let's try this memory thing. I reckon it's gonna change how this is all gonna work. CO2 reader. CO2 writer. And memory. Right, So memory should be set at 1. I'm going to try 1. See what happens with this. Logic memory. 0.8? What? How does it get to 0.8? What mathematical formula is this thing applying? Is it averaging them? Yeah. Yeah, Crazy Fox, you're right. It is an average of the two values. Okay. So there's no way I can do what I was hoping to do. Let's just confirm. So 0.6, if I increase this to, say, 11. Yep. Yep, you're right. It's an average of the two. Well, poop. There's really no way to make this graph display useful in this particular setting, is there? Unless I do... No, because it's the scale. I want to impact the scale, and there's no way to impact the scale. Why don't you give me an option to control the scale on the graph? That's really annoying. You should have a manual graph control. Bah. Oh well. It was worth a try. Try something different. Out. What? How did... So that's the CO2 reader. Which setting do I choose? Setting is the N number. Why is it not showing some of that? Why is it? Oh, it's turned off. 0.570. Well, there we go. Have to use the LEDs. Yeah, Sorakfang, that's what I was hoping I could set up the console to do. So I was hoping it would have different... Oh, wait. Wait a second. What if I use a logic writer to set a mode on the console? Is there a mode option to change it so that it's the console isn't averaging but it's showing the two values? Is there anything you can do that? Because yeah, exactly what Sorakfan was saying, that'd be the ideal way. You send a 1 to set the top value, and then you send the 0.57 or whatever the CO2 is at, as the second, and it'll show in the middle of the graph. I also changed the color. Yes, I probably did. Okay, so 11 is purple. What is 0? Two, three. Okay. Yeah, let's go with that. There we go, that's better than leaving in blue. Right, mode 1 on the LED using a memory. Okay. I'll try that. Mode. Cool. There we are. Oh, yeah, Bedrite, with some logic, you probably could set the color of that to change at certain limits. So you'd need a logic compare. Basically, what I'd have to do so that this would change the color is have... have another logic set up where I take the value 0.57, I compare it against a specific value, and when that equals the correct thing, it changes the color of the display to red or yellow, and then when it reaches a different value, it'll change it back to the previous one. I suspect the amount of logic chips I would need to set something like that up that automatically resets itself would be a lot. So that might be an interesting project to do as an integrated chip, like writing code for, because it seems like a fairly simple way to start. Yeah. Don't know that I'm going to do that today, because that sounds like something that I'm going to get way too involved in. Let's have a look. Be good to have a look, because even if I don't do it today, I'll have a bit of a better idea. Integrated circuit, editor motherboard. Integrated circuit, programmable chip. Steel, electrum, and solder. And I have no steel up here. And nope. Dang it. Deconstruct, don't put it in there. I think I might do shelves instead of lockers. now that I know that shelves are a thing, because I kind of didn't realize that we had the medium shelves now. Because without the doors, they're a lot more convenient. I haven't seen the pipeline mod that Wasted's using in his Agaris save Seraph Faint, so I'm not sure. I don't know enough about it to know how that would work. If you're saying it could be used as a rail. Like how that would advantage over using other blocks. So I'm meaning. No, there are no large shelves. Shelf medium, corner locker. No large shelf. Yeah, no doors is still definitely an upgrade. Doors just make it so hard to see what's going on. Oh, so it's basically a single block that can be very, very long, I see. Ah, oh, that already looks neater. They are. Get this stuff out of there. Make this space a lot easier to navigate. Thanks, Pampy. Thanks for 20 months. This is the same one that's currently being shown as VODs on my second YouTube channel, Flipsy. Same one. I like that you can place them all side by side perfectly like that. That makes them so much more useful than lockers with their stupid doors. Yeah, I suppose I could move this out of, move these ones out one block and then move these ones in. Or just put another one in. Lohin, they were always going to cover windows. I was always going to use, end up covering the windows with lockers and stuff. Didn't think they were corner shelves. I thought they were only corner lockers. Yeah, there's only corner lockers. Which are not particularly useful. would look nice. Though. Actually, maybe I will use the corner one here. Then... I was thinking if I get rid of some of this stuff, I can maybe just cut down the number of shelves I've got. I probably don't need quite so many. Yeah, do that. That looks quite neat. It's a pretty decent amount of storage too. And gives us our windows back. Yeah, I suppose I could do double tall, couldn't I? Just for really hard to reach shelves. Ooh. No, I don't like that. Double tall doesn't look nice at all. Double tall is floaty. Nope. I'm not down with that. That looks better, though. I can put rarely needed stuff up there, so stuff like my old suit. My old tool belt. Don't even know why I'm keeping that old canister. That battery should go in there. And those should stay there. Cool. Looks nice though. Yeah, that looks... I'm so much happy with this space. It's so much better. right. Integrated chip. That's what started all this. Steel, electrum, and solder. I have to go make more steel, or at least go collect some of the stuff that I've got down there. Do some tone decorating. Yeah, the color options in this leave something to be desired for making aesthetic-based color decisions. Let's just bring that one up, rather than making some more right now. Do I see myself doing anything on these floors? Not yet. I do eventually, because I think the... I was going to put the recycling stuff in this room, because apparently it doesn't off-gas. So I was thinking of putting it down the end here, but it also makes more sense to be outside. I'm still not sure what I want to do with that. That's what it comes down to. Electrum, solder. Electrum and solder. Yeah, I think there's going to be some machinery there. I just don't know what. I may end up putting the, like, food canning stuff there, but I feel like that makes more sense up in the living part. Okay. How does this work? How does this work? I need a computer. Ooh. Oh, that's tempting. I'm tempted to put the computers all down here. Like, if I'm going to use computers, they may as well stay down in the production room rather than being cluttering up the space up there. We need a housing. Is there a different housing to the computer? Kit, I see housing. Ah. Because the computer uses the motherboard, which is a different thing again. I will certainly feel like I've achieved something if I manage to get my head around some basics of this. So how do I write stuff to this chip? Do I have to write it in the computer? Need to upload code from the computer and then place the chip and housing at the circuit. I need a motherboard now. IC editor motherboard. That I didn't get a laptop option, Mike. When I scrolled through it, all I got was that. There was no scrolly option. Unless the laptop's a separate thing. Oh, it is a separate thing. That'd be why. Oh, well. It's fine. It's fine. I'm doing it this way. No. Where does the chip go in this thing? How do I upload the code to the chip? Oh, I have to have it connected. I see. I need another... Nope. I see housing, which I then connect to the data from the computer so that I can write to it. Okay, this feels like we're getting somewhere. Rename those so that's something useful. You know what? I am going to put an area power control in here just to isolate this separate, isolate this from the rest of the network. Because I feel like that's potentially going to be useful down the line. Plus, it means I could eventually put a battery in there and have it as a an uninterruptible power supply for the computers. Still really need to set up my own one of those in my office. Do that. Could have just done that. And that would have kept it isolated. I think. Let's check. That should still work because the power's going in, data connection. Sweet. We'll just do that. Makes more sense. I can always use a spare power controller somewhere, I'm sure. Edit. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. How do I even... Where do I even get started with this? Like, how... Like, where do you even start learning how to do the coding? I'm just looking at the wiki right now. Oh boy, okay, that's advanced stuff. I don't want advanced. I want basic. Here we go. Yeah, Darkzan, I've done no programming, pretty much. Arguably little bits. The integrated chip contains 16 registers, R0 to R15. Think of these as variables. To set a register directly, such as R0 equals 2, use the move command. To read a value from a device, use L for load. So what I want to do... L, R0, D0 reads the temperature parameter from device 0 and places the value R0 in R0. Okay, so what I want to start with is reading, what's it called on the sensor? How will I determine what it's called on the sensor? Probably whatever it's called on the input here. Variable. Ratio carbon dioxide. That's what I want to get. So the first value I want is to... So I want to load ratio carbon dioxide from device. How do I determine the device number? How do I tell it what's device zero? So basically what I'm wanting to do is I want to load, I want to get onto the IC, onto the integrated chip. So I figured I figured the best way for me to start this process is to use the integrated chip to display the CO2 value. Start with that. Really, really simple thing. So what I want to do is I want to get that information. Oh, that really freaked me out. That looked like rain. I want to get the information from this gas sensor and I want to display it on this display. That's it. Real simple. Like, hello world level stuff. The IC housing has 6 dials that relate to device 0 to device 5. You set them. Ah, that's what these are. Okay. So device 0, I will set as the gas sensor. Device 1, I will set as the LCD, the CO2 display. Okay, cool. So what I want to start with is, where's my wiki? So I want to set a load command on line 1. So that's load into R0 device 0 ratio carbon dioxide. And then I want to write, which is S according to this, I want to write D1, the value that's in R0. Writes the value from register 0 out to on parameter of device 0. Wait, how do I change which parameter I'm setting that to? Because I don't want it to set it to the... I want to set it to what? Setting. Setting. I need to write setting. No? Why is that red? Red bad? Is it capital S? Yes, capital S. Case sensitivity. So that should be it. Confirm. Export. Okay. Oh, no, I wasn't setting, it was, no, it was setting. Output. Output variable. Setting, yeah. It is setting. Let's turn you off. Let's turn you... Okay, you're still going to stay at that. That's going to be confusing. Before I do that, let's do this. in logic memory. Okay. So now that that is wrong, I can turn this on. Yeah! Yeah! Yeah, yeah, yeah. It worked. Sweet. Success. So I've now got that reading that. Okay, so now what I want to do is mess around with the color that displays. So I'd like to be able to display, make it change. Although I'm not going to be able to test that. I'm going to have to, I'll have to change device zero to the memory, and then I can mess with the numbers. So if I change, if I turn this off, and I change this to logic memory, that's not going to work because this is trying to read a value I don't have. Dang it. How am I going to make this testable so I can have it actually check if it works? I'll have to change it so that I'm just, when I fiddle around with all the other stuff, instead of it being reading the number from ratio carbon dioxide, I need it to read the memory controller so I can mess with it and see what happens as I change things. Yeah, I'm okay with it. It was a run once. It's fine. I'm sure there's a loop thing in a sec. I'll get there. So what I'm just thinking is, I need to read state, I think. I need to read the logic memory state to be able to test this. I'd like to be able to do something more dynamic than just setting it to the value at 57 for each color. State. Nope. State. Nope. Okay, what is the thing for memory? Device variables. Color, combustion, port count, mode, no. Integer for mode state. Different devices will have different mode states. No, I don't think it's mode for memory. Where is it? Memory uses setting. Okay, cool. Setting. Confirm. Export. All right, let's see if this... Oh, that doesn't need to be on. Okay, cool. So if this works, then I should just be able to mess with the numbers on the memory controller. I should probably change the mode of that from 100% though. Yes, I do need to loop the program now. also, why wasn't that changing? I think I'm going to need to fiddle with that and make it just display an integer for time. So, how do I do a loop? Do a do a loop. Probably I would have thought that would be up near the top. Oh, is J jump? Yep. Okay. Confirm. Export. Let's see if this works. I'm hoping this sort of way of thinking will help me when I want to mess with robotics and Lego at some point. So logic writer, I want output variable for the thing to be mode. And I can't remember what mode I need to set for that. Is it mode 0? Yes. Okay, so we've fixed the mode. Let's turn this on now. And let's change the value. And it's working. Okay. That's good. That's working. Yeah, takes from one tin can to another, although this one's a little bit more spacious. Cool. So the next thing I need to do is I need to compare the value against an integer. And then if that value is below a certain number, it should change the color. And then I also need a separate thing to change it back. Oof. This is... I understand how my dog feels when I'm trying to teach her new tricks right now. This is hard. Oof. Branch if equal, branch if not equal, branch if greater than. Is that what I want? Yeah. Branch if less than BLT. Now I'm hungry. Uh-huh. So I think I can... That comments it out. So we'll just comment that one out for the moment. Oh wait, no, I do want to keep that in. So branch less than I'm trying my best to ignore the advanced advice that people are giving me.
Hydration critical.
What? Hydration's critical. Largely because what I want to do is do this really stepwise. Do a little bit, even if it's not the complete solution, just so that I can solidify that learning before moving on to the next thing. Hopefully my struggle through this will be helpful to someone who's trying to learn it. But I'd like to just do little bit, little bit, little bit, little bit, and eventually build up some code that's useful. Because I feel like this is a project I could get finished learning that way. So we'll start with the branch if less than. So how does that actually work? So branch if less than, I'm presuming I then set the line of code that it jumps to. Jump if, yeah. So branch if less than... Let's move this down to here. Range of less than jump to 3. So in three, what I want to do is I want to write to device one color. What colors are there? Let's go orange. Where do I... Yeah, that was my next thing. Where do I tell it branch if less than what? Where's the... stuff on that? Branch two lines C if A is less than B. Okay. Branch two. So three should be the last thing. If A is less than B, if R0 is less than, let's just say 10. Go to 3, change the color to orange. I think that's right. And let's just do a branch greater than R0, 10, 5. S, device one, color, I think color is white. Yeah, white. Why is that in red? Oh, replace it with the number there. Right, sorry, 3. And white is 6. Confirm. Export. Drink. I know that the code will automatically move down, but I only wanted it. Wait. It should. Hang on. How do you make it skip? Like, this will just keep reading down. How do I make it skip line 3 and line 5 if it's not those? Will it automatically skip them? So I need to... Okay. Hang on. Oh, I need to put a jump in here. Jump. 8. Jump 5. And now that needs to change to 4. And that needs to change to 8. And that needs to change to 9. So, as I read this, this will pick up the setting from the memory controller. That'll write it to the screen. If the value is less than 10, it will go to line 4, which skips this jump, and it'll set the color. If it's not, it'll jump to line 5, which skips this line, and then we'll check the greater than, and then it'll keep looping through. Export. 10 on. Because it's greater than 10, it is white. Now it's orange. Yay! It's working! Yeah. Alright, we're getting there. We're getting there. I've got about... I got enough time to possibly get this working before I need to take Charlie to the vet. Okay. So, what else did I want to do? I wanted to change it to red if it gets really low. So, we can basically repeat this code but set lower values in it for the next bit. So, branch less than... R0, 1, 2, and we'll set that to color red, 4. No, wait, what am I doing? Branch of less than 2, go to 11. No, 12. Jump, 13. Right, device one, color, 4. Now, is this going to be an issue? Bellacrack, I don't care that I'm doing more jumps than necessary, to be brutally honest. Getting something that works here is a lot more important than doing something optimal. One of the biggest challenges of learning in this sort of environment is focusing on just actually learning rather than focusing on trying to learn the exact perfect thing first. It's much more important to just learn. To get something that works than it is to get something that works optimally when you're right at the start. And so I'm just trying to make something that works, and then once I feel that I've got that knowledge fairly concrete and firmly understand what I'm doing, then I can make it easier, then I can optimize it later. There are a lot of reasons why learning the best thing first is not actually the best way to do it. There's a reason why in chemistry we don't teach kids the advanced stuff at the beginning. We teach them really basic stuff because once they get those concepts, they can learn in the situations in which they're wrong and then optimize that learning and build on that firm base. Because putting too many layers in to begin with means people can easily get overwhelmed and not actually learn anything at all. That's oxygen, right? White oxygen.
Air tank critical.
Yeah, physics is a great example. You don't teach quantum physics to primary school kids. You teach them the basics of how gravity works in most situations. You don't teach them really high-level stuff because it doesn't get them anywhere. It just gets them frustrated.
Air tank critical.
That'll do. I get that there are some bad habits that you can learn with coding that might be an issue over time. you want to... yeah, that was a bad example, Skedwin. Gravity was not a good choice. I was thinking with chemistry, like, you teach them about the basics of covalent bonds, but you don't teach them why all that works. But there are... I can get why there are issues with learning suboptimal processes to begin with in coding, but I think if I tried to learn the absolute perfect way to begin with, I wouldn't learn anything at all. So the and I think most people learn better that way. Certainly was the way that I learned about teaching when I did my when I was doing my master's that I didn't finish. But I still learned a lot of useful stuff from. I'm gonna need so what I was thinking about just before I wrote, was running out of oxygen. I'm going to need a variable within these less than and greater thans to ignore when it's even below a certain level. I need to actually do a separate branching within it rather than doing an additional one down here. Otherwise, it's going to keep flicking back between the two colors as it runs through the code. So, let's think this through. Let's get rid of these because they're just going to confuse me for the moment and they're not necessary. So, functions. I guess what I could do is I can use this function to do it. So, if it is less than 10, jump to line 4. If it is less than 2, jump to line 7 will probably be. This will jump to 8. And on line 7, S, D1, color. Or which was red, I think. Yeah. After a color changes, jump to end of all changes. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's a good point, Mike. Leaving notes is useful. I was in a really good habit of leaving comments in my setup for the Assertive Combat Systems mod. However, if you do a comment that's all more than a single line, it frequently breaks the ability for space engineers to read those XML files. And the mod breaks. I don't know if that's been fixed, but when I was doing it, it was breaking it. So I couldn't just comment out chunks of code that I was backing up for use in the future. And it's just... It was really unfortunate. Oh, Takari, Aizen knows exactly what ACS is. He's just being cheeky. Yeah, let's write some comments. So check if device R0 has value less than 10. If value, oh, it's a value. Value R0. Let's learn the terms properly, Splitzy. That'd be helpful. Less than 2. Alright. Check if value R0 less than 2. Jump to 7. So, if value is less than 10, jump to 4. If it's greater than 10, we'll have to set up where this jumps to. Leave that. I'll have to fix that up in the end. That's going to be really annoying. I'm going to potentially mess those up quite a bit. Less than 2, we skip past changing it to orange and we go straight to red. And then we, I guess, could jump to the end. Or jump to 0, I guess. No, I'm just going to leave that. I'm going to leave that. That's fine. Doesn't matter if I do the other compares afterwards. Because I want to just keep doing, running it through, comparing. So that should be fine. So let's jump to 8 on that one. Jump to 8. So that should change it to orange or red. Because basically what I've got this doing is getting the value, comparing the value if it's less than 10. If it's greater than 10, it'll move on to this line, which will then jump it down to here, where we're going to do our comparing if it's greater than things to change the colors back. If it's less than 10, it'll jump down to here, where it then gets compared to see if it's less than 2. If it's greater than 2, it moves on to the next line, changes it to orange, and then jumps past this one. If it's less than 2, it jumps to this, gets changed to red, and then moves on to the other compares. So now we're going to our greater than, and we're going to do basically the same thing. There is a bit of a an issue with what I've done here, which is I kind of wanted to do greater than or equal to, but I'm not too fussed if it stays orange when it hits the exact value and then goes above, because hitting the exact value when I'm actually using the gas amounts is almost never going to happen. So that edge case, I don't really care if it stays red as I'm improving things slightly longer than it should, and equally stays white slightly longer than it should as it's getting worse. The time difference in those is not going to be an issue for me. Yeah, the reason I didn't want to the greater than or equal to was I thought that would add more complexity in the fixing, in the changing it back. BGE branch greater or equal. Actually, you're right. If I do just the greater than ones, greater than or equal, changing it back, then that would work. Branch greater than or equal to value in R0, 10, We're going to jump to 11. So if it's not greater than or equal to 10, it can just jump straight back to 0 and restart the loop. Then we go, this line needs to be branch greater than or equal R0 to jump to 12. No, jump to 14. Then that sets that to there. That jumps back to 0. Line 14 will be SD1 color orange, which is 3. Nope, I don't know about labels for jumps. I will look into that, as I'm sure that would be useful so I don't have to define specific lines to jump to. I'm guessing that's what that means. Let's just run through this again. Okay, branch greater than or equal to. So if I've got a value of 11... Oh wait, I need to do this the other way around. 2, 11, 3... 6. So if I've got a value of 11, it's greater than 2. It's greater than or equal to 2. So we will jump down to line 11. 11 is greater than or equal to 11. So we will jump down to 14, which will set us back to white. If we have a value of 6, it's greater than or equal to 2. So we jump down to here. It's not greater than or equal to that, so we jump down to here, which sets us to orange. We then jump back to 0 and start it all over again. Yay! Confirm. Export. Let's see how we go. Also, thank you everybody for your patience in letting me figure this out. I am actually enjoying myself. Okay, 13 is white. 12. 11. 10 is orange. 9. 8. 3. 2 should be orange. 1 will be red. 0 will be red. Yeah. Okay, so now what I need to do, because that code works. I should check to make sure it works the other way. Yep, back to orange, back to white. Yay! So, with that working, oh, we're down to 33 degrees in here. Perfect, this is going well. Now what I need to do is pick values for CO2 that I want highlighted. Which means... Does this show what the tomato plant can tolerate? Well, I have to go to the wiki for that. Eating through my nails, trying not to scream at all the suboptimal things. Yep. All right, what does it say? All right, build an entire pressure. Somewhere pressure. What? Where's the CO2 though? 40 kilopascals with a minimum 1% carbon dioxide. So it's actually really low. But I probably want to be notified when it's less than 5%. And then it goes red when it's less than 2% or something. So what I was thinking of doing, once I've got this working for CO2, I can use the same code and write it onto a separate one that works for O2. So I've got monitoring for mine. So I need this changed from setting to ratio carbon. Oh man, what is wrong with my typing? Dioxide. Not rato, ratio. That remains as setting. Now the ratio, what was it reading as? What values was it giving me? Because now that I've got the thing back to not displaying in percentages, what values is this giving me? Oops, I need to change the device. Gas sensor. 0.570. Okay, cool. Wait a second. Can I use the code here to change the way it displays that value? I'll just change the way the display is working. All right, so how do I set the mode? So that's what I want to do. So this should not be 10. It should be 0.2. No. 0.05. And this should be 0.02. And this should be 0.02. And this should be 0.05. And what the heck? At the end here, let's just write in SD1 mode device variables. Was mode 1. Confirm. Export. Yeah. I did the thing. It works. That's really cool. That feels really cool. that feels really cool. I don't think I've picked my projects very well for trying to learn this sort of stuff in the past. And it's why I thought learning it in Station Ears, learning it in with Lego stuff would be a really good way to learn it, because I figured I would find smaller, little, well-contained, but still interesting to me, projects to work on to learn this stuff. But because looking at things like making a mod, making that sort of stuff, it overwhelms me quite quickly, I find. Whereas a simple little project like this, you can break it down. Even I can break it down into really simple stuff. Yep. I'm actually going to have to wrap this up here so I can take Charlie to the vet, but I'm actually really excited to come back to this next week and mess around with more little things like this. Like, obviously I'll need to set up an O2 thing. I'm going to need to put labels on these. Oh, actually, quickly before we wrap up, is there a way that I can send letters to this display and then have it display the percentage afterwards, so I could have this display literally say CO2 57% on one display? Is that possible, or is that beyond what the display and the coding stuff here is capable of doing? Yes, but that's a lot more code. Okay, so that's maybe not a today thing. That's a... Okay, next week what I'd like to learn is how to write a specific strings that I've got in storage on code to this. Oh, it's definitely easier to put a sign above it, but where's the fun in easy? Oh, that's a great idea, Iron Helix. Instead of having it say CO2 and 57% together, which might not fit with the number of pixels here, have it flicking between saying CO2 and the percentage with a timer and a wait between the two. Okay, cool. That might be a cool way of doing it. And that'd be a neat way of doing it as well. And then I could get silly and try and cram the CO2 and the O2 onto the same one and have it say CO2 this, O2 this, CO2 this, O2 this. Or put a big LCD up and have it display both at the same time. That could work too. But cool. As I said at the end of the Tin Can stream earlier this morning, I will be back tomorrow with probably Capac and Pav for some more... We're thinking Icarus, but there might be a change coming soon, depending on how the two other guys feel about it, to maybe even something completely different. But yeah, I'll be back with some more Icarus tomorrow night. And then back with some more scavenger hunt on Saturday. This is all that and plenty more to come. And I will see you then. And thank you everyone in chat for your help with getting me to understand this. That feels really cool. See you everyone.